Most of you know me. I'm Jim Hennon. I'm an AMSU instructor. I've done training for you for many years. What we're doing today is shake hands with danger. Somebody said we ought to call it high five for danger and take it out a little bit. But fellas, what we've done in the past, we've always done the old film, which you're going to see some of it in this training. But shake hands with danger is what we've done to let you know the dangers that's out there. And most people don't really think about it. They get the complacency. They take the shortcuts. And they don't really see the danger because they've done it so many times and got by with it. Climbing, when you're climbing on something, it's just going to take a minute. And a minute can get you hurt. You don't put your life jacket or don't put your harness on. If you get above your waist, you're supposed to have a harness. People have climbed on equipment. I've seen it just recently. Fella was climbing on the back of a truck and got up to do something. There was frost on it and slipped off. Didn't hurt him. He was lucky. He walked away, kind of limped, and he said, "I done a stupid thing." That's what we do. We do stupid things sometimes. We make those mistakes by thinking we can get by with it. You can't get by with it because sooner or later, that mistake's going to cost you. Sticking your hand in the wrong place. Climbing on something. Getting in around a piece of equipment that's operating and it's supposed to be turned off, locked out, tagged out, and we all do it. We're just going to take that minute. That minute can cost you. It might cost you a limb, but it could cost you your life. Fellas, we can't take those chances. Most of you are pretty good about your safety. Mountain has really done good as far as safety-wise. You know, it shows that you all are doing a good job. But sometimes we still make those mistakes. Those mistakes cost. So don't do that anymore. Always look at your surroundings. Make sure it's safe for you to go in and do the job that you're supposed to. Check your equipment. Whatever your equipment's supposed to have or whatever it's supposed to do, make sure you've done it. If it means checking the engine, checking the oil, checking your brakes, all of that counts. Most people just assume that, hey, it was working yesterday, it's working today. That's not the case. A lot of times, things deteriorate overnight. And when they do, and you get in it and you don't check it, then we've got problems. You need that walk around. Look at that piece of equipment. Make sure that everything on it is working. Check the lights. Check the brakes. Check your water, your oil. All of that counts. Don't depend on somebody else to do it. It's your responsibility as well as whoever doing the fueling or whatever. A lot of people think that, hey, that's the other guy's job. No, it's your job. Your job is to check your piece of equipment so it's ready every day. Not the other man, yours. Look at your surroundings. Make sure it's safe for you to do what your job is. Always be aware of other people, other pieces of equipment around you, moving around. Don't take those chances. It happens time and time again. Every year we have incidents out there that people took those chances. People get run over. They don't think about it. They don't hear the piece of equipment. They're kind of like me. I've got hearing aids. If I don't put them on, I don't hear well. So piece of equipment moving around, if I'm not there, if I don't have them on, then what happens is I don't hear it. So I don't take that chances. I usually, just like my glasses, every morning, I put them on. First thing I do after that is usually put my hearing aids on so I can hear my wife too, because she kind of picks at me and she'll say, "Don't you hear me?" And I'll say, "Sure, I heard you. I just didn't understand you." And that happens a lot. She says it's selective hearing. Could be a little bit. But yeah, we've got to not take those chances. When you're around chemicals and things, in around the job sites, be sure that you got the proper equipment. If you got to move something, that you got splash aprons, you got shields, you got your gloves that you have to wear. All that is important. Any type of safety equipment that you have to have on the job site, around MSHA, if it's required, you must have it on. You can't take that chance, because if they walk in and you don't have that piece of equipment on, they can write you up. Nobody wants to get wrote up, and what happens today is that they're writing the individuals, not the company, the individuals. And I've seen that happen here just recently, because a guy didn't have his hard hat on. He took the chance. He was just going to be there a minute. And it wasn't MSHA, though. It was State. And State come in on the job, and he seen him. And he actually took the picture and proved to him that he didn't have it on. He was just outside of his piece of equipment for about 2 minutes. So anything that you have to have, make sure that you have that piece of safety equipment on, whether it's a harness, hard hat. Some places require steel-toed shoes. Whatever it is, make sure you've got it, because if you go in on a job site, permitted property, MSHA and State both are looking. They've got to have something anymore, because there's not enough work out there. So they're looking for something, even if it's just a tail light or a brake light or whatever on your piece of equipment. They can write it if they want to. Some of these inspectors are real good. They know that this things are slowed down. COVID's caused a lot of it. And so they're trying to be nice about it and give you a little warning. But sometimes they have to put something on paper to show that they're actually doing their job. Everybody wants to keep their job. So shake hands with danger. Don't stick your hand in something that's moving. Make sure it's locked out, tag out. Don't get around a piece of equipment that's moving on the yard and they can't see you. Always, if it's on the left side, make sure that that operator can see you. Right side, got blind spots. In front, blind spots. Behind, blind spots. So you're a little object out there on that yard. Make sure that you get where they can see you. If that's not possible, if you got radios or whatever, make sure that you get in contact with them. Because a lot of times, that operator, he's doing his job, and he's trying to keep everything operating, and he's not watching everything around him. He's not looking at the big, broad picture. He's just got what we call in the fire service, tunnel vision. And he's just seeing what's right in front of him most of the time. And that's a lot of times what happens with accidents. Those accidents happen, and there have been people lost their lives or lost limbs. Don't take those chances. Now, shake hands with danger.
I can check that gear in a minute, so don't touch anything, okay? By accident, you'd be mincemeat by now. What have I told you? You don't work on equipment when the engine's running.
Well, I told him not to touch anything. All right, I guess I wasn't thinking.
You weren't thinking? You mean you'll work on engines and machinery and not think of your own personal safety? Here, shake hands with danger.
Shake hands with danger. Need a guy who ought to know. I used to laugh at safety. Now they call me Three Finger Joe. Shake hands with danger, find it anywhere you choose. Be careless for a moment, spend a lifetime with the blues. Earth-moving machines are designed for safety, but they're big enough to hide a man.
Earthfella, just about dead. You could have killed me.
This mechanic is lucky he's able to complain. He should have protected himself by removing the key and putting a do not operate tag on the controls. Anytime you pick up a wrench, reach for a control, use a grease gun, grab a welding torch, or work on any machine, while forgetting safety, you're shaking hands with danger.
Go! All right?
Okay.
All right, now you take the loader up behind the hill where they're working. Now I'll drive up on the road and I'll meet you at the top, all right?
Okay, but you know, Cliff, I never operated this model before.
All right, all I have to do is back it up and then let it down nice and easy like. You want me to do it?
No, I can handle it. There's no sweat there.
What this man didn't know was that the operator had left the lift lever in the raised position, so the arms would rise automatically when the engine started. A qualified operator would have known better. The man shouldn't have tried to perform as an operator when he wasn't one.
Well, you were kidding when you said you didn't know how to run that thing.
Chuck Hamlin is no beginner. Before he begins changing an O-ring on an excavator boom, he checks. Oil temperature down, engine off, bucket grounded, hydraulic lock engaged. Okay, he'll have that O-ring installed in minutes. A minute, but you may damn well lose it all. Wherever possible, the stick should be extended and the boom lowered so the work can be done at ground level. Finding that impossible, the next man used the service truck as a safe work platform. Climbing with tools can create a hazard. Use the steps and the grab irons. Keep at least 3 points of contact, 2 feet and one hand unencumbered. Any shortcuts and you're inviting injury. In fact, taking shortcuts is often a quick road to trouble. For example, consider what happened to Harry Sanders. Harry has come to work with a problem. His son is having a football-injured knee operated on this morning. Harry wants to finish this job and take a couple hours off to visit his son. The operator has complained that the scraper is shifting too slow and the controls are sluggish. In a hurry, Harry pulls only one axle. The service manual says to pull both axles and disconnect steering. But Harry knows with one axle removed and the differential unlocked, the machine shouldn't move. He's taken this shortcut before. While waiting for the operator to return, Harry starts the machine in order to judge the problem. While he waits for the engine to warm, Harry's thoughts drift to worries about his son. The accelerator feels stiff, so then he checks the feel of the service brakes. His attention is divided. While thinking about his son, his hands and feet go through motions he believes have become automatic. In this absent-minded state, he unconsciously starts to steer, jams his foot on the differential lock, and the machine takes off. Lucky for the stunned operator, the machine stops itself. Harry is only bruised, but in a crowded area, he could have killed someone because he ignored safe procedure to save a few minutes' work. Now, most people have days when they come to work with worries, hangovers, or distractions. Those are times for being doubly cautious. When the body's on the job, but the mind is elsewhere, it's danger time. Glenn Greenwood was victim of another kind of mental hazard, ego.
How you doing, hotshot?
Yeah, it's stuck in there tight.
Did you get that pin driver?
No, but I got this drift. Just give it a whack.
Glenn knows the risk of striking hard against badly chipped metal. But he's wearing safety glasses, and there's a macho thing involved here. Glenn doesn't want his friend to sneer at him for being overly cautious. So, Glenn shakes hands with danger. Maybe his friend would have laughed if Glenn had insisted upon playing it safe. But he sure as hell isn't laughing now. With tools, the time to make sure you have a safe ending is before you start using them. They should be the right tools for the job and in safe condition. If Glenn's friend had ground off that mushroomed face, taken care of the tools he uses, he could have prevented that accident. Some old-timers think accidents happen only to greenhorns.
Hey, Red. I got a bracknell. You want to come take a look at it?
Let them learn the hard way, they say. Now, let them learn the hard way can be an attitude that results in serious injury.
Doc, sorry about that.
One word of caution from the old-timer would have saved a lot of pain and lost work time. And even the old-timer can lapse into carelessness. The safety gap is correct when he starts, but he doesn't think about how much he's grinding down the wheel. He gets by with it on that longer piece. Shake hands with danger, step right up and say hello. Grinding wheels and metal are what made Three Finger Joe. Fingers aren't the only things to think about when working with track. near miss due to the mechanic's failure to restrain the track before he unloosened it at a high point. Here, they're about to push a high sprocketed machine from an old set of tracks onto a new set. With both tracks removed, the machine is free to roll. On a slight grade, it may just take off.
Hey, get away from me!
If they'd had an operator in the machine, he could have stopped it by dropping the ripper or blade. Now, they should have planned proper blocking and restraint. But better still, they should change one track at a time. Then there can't be a rollaway.
What have we got going here, huh?
Hurry and failure to heed safety warnings can also endanger those doing routine maintenance. Despite warnings about hot oil and pressure systems, some optimist always thinks he can get his hand away in time.
Oh, God! Somebody help me.
Needn't have happened. The temperature gauges, pressure gauges, and the safety caps on cooling systems are there to prevent accidents from occurring. The people who shake hands with danger are those who don't learn beforehand what they're getting into. Like the owner whose brake rotor chamber has been losing air pressure.
Hey, Sam!
I got the brake chamber off the loader. I gotta run into the dealers to get some repair parts. While I'm gone, will you take it apart to save us some time?
Okay, Bill.
At this point, the service manuals call for the insertion of a threaded tool to hold the spring force. Sam hasn't read the manual. He doesn't know he's releasing a force that might be as high as 1,750 pounds. Whether you're working on anything from nitrogen accumulators to inflated tires, it pays to know the kind of power you're dealing with beforehand. The warnings about gasoline are as old as use of the fuel. Yet somewhere, somebody is always deciding it won't hurt to use it as a cleaning fluid just this one time. Oh, he'll empty the pan very carefully, just as soon as he finds a rag to wipe off the carburetor. Meanwhile, the fuel keeps vaporizing.
Hey, I've only got about another hour to go on this thing. I gotta get that thing washed over there. I'll be down in a minute.
It's possible to become overconfident about handling dangerous materials. A good reason why safety instructions should be repeated at frequent intervals. Oddly enough, it isn't lack of familiarity with a job that causes most accidents. Often it's the routineness of the work that makes a person overconfident. Now, Bill Myers is changing buckets, a job he's done at least 100 times. If he were new at it, Bill would be watching and thinking about every step. Now it's so routine that caution has been dulled. The hole is dry. The pin won't slide in. There's no stick or swab in the grease can, but he could surely find one if he took the time to search around. This is the moment, that split second when a man decides between being safe or shaking hands with danger. If he couldn't find a stick or a swab, Bill could have had the linking members moved apart and greased them separately. It would have been a nuisance, but Bill Myers would give anything to be able to go back and do it the right way.
Hey, Ernie?
Yeah, I got this hose off of the dozer blade here. Why don't you put this bolt in that end? I'm going to take this into the shop.
All right, I'll get it done.
Both push arms, and he should never have relied upon anything as unstable or crushable as building blocks. Improper blocking and failure to block are major causes of crushing accidents. We're dealing with enormous weight, and we should never depend upon hydraulics alone to hold it up.
Something back here. Ted, the position this truck bed was in without these locking pins in, and you working underneath the truck bed, and it had failed, you'd have had it.
So, okay.
These pins should be in place as such.
Now, it's always important to look out for the other guy. Safety is always in the hands of people on the job. The warnings and cautions are there for those who heed them. Safety procedures are spelled out and illustrated in lubrication and maintenance guides, operators' guides, and service manuals. The protection is there in machine design and safety devices. Safety instruction, emphasizing knowledge and awareness, prevents accidents by encouraging safety consciousness. And protective clothing helps shield the body from the unexpected. The human element remains. It can lend itself to safety or turn a routine situation into a dangerous one.
Hey, Bob!
And we all know that the serviceman doesn't always work under ideal conditions. Mechanic Bob Murray is an excavator with a dead engine. It won't start, which means the brakes are locked, which means it's going to sit right here until Bob disconnects the final drives. Then he'll have a machine he can move. What he should also have, but doesn't, is a second vehicle to provide braking. Shake hands with danger, hurry up and get it done. It takes two men to move this thing, but I'll make do with one. Bob isn't dumb. He wouldn't try towing it all the way to the shop without help. But he just wants to drag it 100 yards or so and get that foreman off his back. Thank you. will never again tow a freewheeling machine without having control over the braking. Now, Bob was lucky. Others were not. Shake hands with danger. 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 And friends I used to know, compared to them I'm lucky to be just Three-Finger Joe.